Greetings, Benjamin J. the Big Troll Guy with another in the series. I've just built this new speaking tube. I wanted to try it out. Thought I'd do a video of the first test. This is a much larger bell than I've used before. Approximately the same length of the tube itself, about 7 inches. And I'm just really curious to see what kind of recording this is going to make. You can put almost your entire mouth directly into this bell, so it should make a good, efficient recording horn. We're going to find out anyway. A speaking tube made out of copper and brass. Like I said, an extremely large bell, about 4 inches. So let's see how this works. Greetings and salutations. Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy making an acoustic recording on the electric cylinder phonograph, recording on a brown wax cylinder. This is an old cylinder that I keep in the shop for doing test recordings. Testing this new speaking tube. This is a copper tube about 7 inches long with a 4-inch brass bell. So, extremely large bell, which covers most of my mouth. So, like I said, this should make a really efficient acoustic recording horn. So, let's find out. In any case, just a quick test recording on the electric cylinder phonograph, a straight acoustic recording using the new speaking tube. As always, if you have any questions, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching. All right, there's some noise on the cylinder, but it's just an old, noisy cylinder. Excuse me. Blow the swarf away. And occasionally clean off your stylus and your reproducer with a little dental brush. These work really well. All right, so I'll play this back through. I'll play it back through a witch's hat one. So, let me move the camera. Well, that should be sufficient, I think. Shooting this with my iPad on a tripod. So here's the recording.
Electric cylinder phonograph.